mentally, I was in probably the lowest place I've ever been in my life. The reason I moved into the YMCA was when I was 17, I was unfortunately made homeless. I didn't know what I was doing with my life, where I was going. I don't think I was integrated into society at all. There's no other way of describing what I was like or who I was, apart from a dosser.
I was born with cerebral palsy and I'm profoundly deaf. And because of this, I have lots of pain in my legs. I've had to have physiotherapy ever since I was little. And when I was younger, I used to have a frame. I wanted to move to Exeter to be independent. I wanted to meet new people, and I've been really happy here. I lived in YMCA for 2 years.
As my mum's disabled, she had a stroke when she was 10 years old, so I've been caring for her for about a good 16 years, just trying to give support to my mum, trying to get respected for who we are. The doctors referred me to YMCA Young Carers Group. Seeing other people in the same situation as I am, when anything goes wrong, like, we all stick together like a big family.
I managed to get an interview with the YMCA and I was given the opportunity to move in here. Didn't know how to cook, I didn't know how to use a washing machine, how to clean. So the amount of support I got was amazing. You need to reach out for the support and accept the support before it can help. The YMCA is not just somewhere to live and somewhere to stay, but it's somewhere to improve yourself and make yourself better.
Now I teach at the local Deaf Academy every week. I have also become a wheelchair champion at a national competition. I've played an important role in the resident community, inputting into meetings that help shape the running of this YMCA. Now the future looks really bright for me.
We've recently set up a youth forum group called PAVE. We're about to launch new handbooks for the young carers. They'll be able to get help from the books, see what numbers to call if they need help. We've had so many more young carers join. It makes me feel like really proud to know that everyone's sticking together, trying to get more help for the young carers, because not many people know about the young carers. We've recently set up our own new app for our young carers to help save money. It's called Starter Chef. We got approved for the Legacy Grant because I thought of the idea to create the app. It's got like a shopping list, you've got various recipes on it.
I got given an amazing opportunity last year to go volunteering in Romania. I've been given an opportunity to be an ambassador, a YMCA youth ambassador. I'm kind of giving a bit back. I didn't realise how big the YMCA was. It's everywhere you go, it interconnects you. The person that moved into the YMCA 2.5 years ago is completely different to the person I am now. It's given me an ambition, it's given me something that I really enjoy. In 20 years' time or 10 years' time or even 2-3 years' time, I can give back to people, I can help people like I've been helped by the YMCA. I want to stay involved, I want to carry it on.
Life has been up and down for me at times. But I'd like to say thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone at YMCA for all your help. You've made me very happy.
Providing a voice for the young carers, I think it's helping other people get heard. It's made her feel quite proud. Like, she's seen me like go through like a difficult journey, going quite a fair way to help her. If it wasn't for YMCA, I think I'd still be struggling right now.